off in the first place, and I will give you an all. To get pissed off and stuck just like me, you will need to get death trippers. I like to fight, and I like to get mad. Today, kill, don't get pissed. I am just getting mad because I like to be mad. I like the new way he is yelling, so get even more mad. And even do anything with your words. But please don't start to hit me because I will be hurt and I will be in pain.
Also, I will like to feel like a dork as stupid as I can, because it is so easy if I don't fight back and convince myself, I will just be some kid. And that hurts me to be a fuck, and I will love to be as stupid and sad as I am, and I'm not going to be a fuck.
Then there was this kid who was on the street who asked some girl to give him money. Then didn't money just be touching? Don't be extra touching.
So I own this house where I sit and I get in a fight. Kids are like mommies. And I like to do this to a real stupid
enemy who I didn't know. And now I am the worst enemy of everyone in this life.
Stand up for my soul. And what is not what I like in this stuff. Then I also like to feel power about things. And get to win. Get lots of things happen to me and to others. So I just skip around this little life that is on the ground, and I try not to kill it for as long as you can. But I know it will be hard because I was the first to kill the dead cat in every life that I saw in this new machine that looks in every life at 20 times per second. That is not a good invention because it's the most powerful drug on the planet, and it makes people go crazy and take over and kill in the worst way.
So I decided to buy a good share of this and give it to all my friends and see who already took this stuff and killed me more than I thought was possible. Today, these people came down and tore me apart, and I still lived, but I was pretty mad, so I made sure they were helped by the best mind workers. Now, is this story of this feeling in my hand that is so painful I can hardly stand it death? I am the one who did all the work in my head, and this guy said he is, and it made this girl feel like crap because she thought she was in the middle of a fight. So, middle of fight equals do all work. Now, I also did research on these kids who like to watch TV and pretend that they are the stars of the show, and they get confused and really think they are them. And they are, but their moms hit them because they won't listen. Then the kid dies of internal injuries, and the mom kills the other kids because they tell the cops. This is strange to me because you rarely see a woman who would do such a thing. Also, on drugs, I met this demon guy who I kicked it with, and then he got mad at this human liver, and he paid me to kill her, so I did. And then I got put in jail because they said I did it for no reason. Then I used my free life pass that I got when I saved the universe for living to transport myself to this interdimensional meeting with all these cool people I am. And then I got fed up and they killed me and I went into this hiding on this mountain for 4 years.
I wrote a book of transmissions from God. And these aliens paid me very well to let them read. With this ultimate supply of drugs, I went to live in cartoons for about 4 years. And when I came back, I was a mass murderer. So I forgot about that and ended up in a mental hospital. And I felt great that I was now in a safe, paid-for place.
But about 10 minutes later, I was about 4 years old on a playground with Starcle Manny swing sets. Then I played and grew up as this kid and lived to be about 40, and finally realized that I keep dying every second, and it is very destructive to my life, and not to mention the death traps I'm leaving everywhere. But then I was this kid who fell into one of my own death traps, and I was two of the worst people I know. But it got much worse when I could not stop doing everything all at once, and death was bad and it flew through me back and forth at very fast speed, and I felt tortured.
But then, Some aliens said to people that I was only on LSD, and my mom and everyone believed them. So I didn't want to be crazy, and I went along with it, but I fought back and turned into a god, and turned into something I made, the Starcle Man symbols. I stood behind them and had fun at these transmission concerts and listened to Five Starcle Men tapes, but then I said I was running with the devil. Hey, and then I killed his ass. And then I killed his ass.
And then I had a heart attack because I killed myself once again, because what I thought was the devil was my friend. In other words, I was put back in jail because the judge thought I was crazy and making this story up. This time, I was in jail for about 10 years because for some reason, I said I didn't have any superpowers. Then in jail, some guy kicked my ass because I talked to him for about 5 years about what I was, and he said I was mean because I didn't tell anyone. But then aliens came through the roof and killed him because he made me look bad. I was the stupid one, though, so I tried to kill myself, but metal plate Starcle Men came in between me and the bullets. Meanwhile, I was in a mental hospital because all I said every 5 seconds was, "The aliens did it. The aliens did it."
And I thought I had a gun in my hand. Just when I started to be able to talk to humans, the aliens sent a crazy doctor to me who made me take this super-powered mental progress drug. And I warped to this experimental government research dimension where animals experience your thoughts. In other words, I thought I was trapped in the body of an animal. So now that I knew I was this crazy, I used this to give me superpowers, and I lived in TV shows.
When I got born and made everything and turned into gods again and made myself feel stupid like I loved so much, I got poor and got a job and turned myself into an individual person who wished I was famous. Then I started to do drugs that made me hallucinate, and I remembered that everything is real and that I'm nothing and that I have.